Hi everyone, Krav-Maga students, fans, instructors, all over the world, maybe from different organizations except KMG. I would like to talk a little bit about Imi, where this time, this month of January, is 20 years since he passed away. Imi was a unique person, definitely. First of all, he was a genius in giving the best solution for a specific problem. So really, if you look at Krav-Maga, at least the first few decades, was problem-solving system. That's it. Imi by himself, I met him when I was about 15. He was 64. So in his 64th birthday, I was just a beginner. And the guys in the club made the cake. Imi had a 64th birthday. I saw an old man, relatively, age of my grandparents. A few months after, I started training with him, and I discovered a very tender person, definitely with the iron fist. But overall, what he was interested in was teaching us, teaching the world, self-defense. He used to say, everybody will come my way, meaning the way of Krav Maga. I became very close to him after touring in the US in 81. And there I could see a gentleman, he was 71 years old, and every second night almost, we had demonstrations. And he was one of the demonstrators. We were a few younger people, and he was demonstrating. So never tired. Never without patience. People were asking questions, he would answer. And a lot of things that I learned from him in the main was his integrity, his behaving to human beings, his behaving to cats, to dogs, to kids. The way he was tender with everybody, the way he was soft. Until it came to his system, where he was like a lion, defending and preaching what he wanted and the way things should be as problem solving. He used to tell us many stories, especially about his times in Bratislava, in Slovakia, where he was a sportsman and competitor in boxing, wrestling, gymnastics, and also fighting the fascists, as he was the head of the informal group of mainly Jewish guys who were defending the Jewish quarters. And he was the uncrowned leader and also instructing them, he was teaching them some fighting skills and some self-defense skills. He was also telling about his father that was chief of detectives, but also had a background in the circus. He was telling us different stories from the father. One of the main things I remember, once he came to his father and says, he was a teenager. Father, when the policeman is facing a person that tried to stab him with a knife, why don't you kick him from a distance? Father said, kicking is not the gentleman way. So Imi was definitely preaching about kicking from a long distance. Although he was not a natural kicker, he would correct us, the young guys, who were quite good kickers. He had a very good eye for, you know, identifying biomechanics moves and saying directing and teaching the right move and the right posture and the right structure for impact. His way to Israel back then, Palestine, was full of adventures, and he almost died on the way. His service in the Czech Legion under the British command, his times in the resistance in Israel, his times in the army, these were things that he would tell us about, for us to know how like his life was flowing on one hand, and of course to learn from his experience, events that he had. You know, usually a person tells some stories, and from time to time the story is becoming a bit more pink or a little bit more extravagant or a bit more fame for himself. Never. Imi is always, told story always the way they were. So if it was 10 years after, he said the same. 20 years after, it stayed the same. I spent many hours, thousands of hours with him at his home, sometimes in his bedroom, talking. He was lying on the bed. And, you know, sometimes I would ask him a question. So while lying on the bed, thinking and visualizing and feeling a technique, he had this nature. He could do it. He could manage to understand situations and techniques and body postures and body movements while not doing anything. Although one time I remember he was already over 85. And I came to him with a question. I remember exactly. It was against a submachine gun threat. And Imi said, oh, I need the weapon. He could not visualize or feel what was the situation. That was very rare. But I remember this, so we took something like a stick, something like a sword, and we trained with that one in his living room near the dinner table. He didn't brag, Imi. He was not saying fame things about himself. It was very simple, even with his stories. I remember one time among us, the teenagers, let's say, there was a rumor that once Imi was standing in the queue to buy a ticket to the cinema, and three guys came and they wanted to shove in the line and buy before. And he punched the three of them. That was the story among us kids. And when I was a teenager, it sounds quite nice how this, it looked like some sort of actor in the Hong Kong Kung Fu movies punching guys in the street. And then, you know, years after, I just remembered this story for a moment and I asked him. Imi said, never happened. What did happen? Oh, he was standing in a line, three youngsters came in, tried to buy ticket in front of everybody, and he said to them, stop guys, you will not buy before I do. That's it. That's the whole incident. So he didn't punch anybody, he just talked. And when I look at his stories, when I recall his stories of self-defense and fighting that are not related to sports, but mainly against the fascists, it was no alternative. There were attackers, people attacked, multiple opponents most of the time. He said sometimes there was no option to give a person two strikes because there were so many people. So if you focus too much on one person, you'll get a strike from another person. So there was no alternative. And or the atmosphere was as such the attitude towards him, towards his guys, towards his friends was so obnoxious, anti-Semitic and swearing, and so he would maybe punch somebody without any strike first that was sent towards him. So, but most of the time, the main thing was he was acting out of no alternative, out of self-defense, out of defending the group, defending the quarters, defending the family, defending the area. So out of this experience, together with the wrestling, together with boxing, if you think about it, Imi was a mixed martial artist. He mixed boxing and wrestling and street fighting, what he had, and what his father was teaching him regarding self-defense. He was mixing all this stuff in his reality. But when things went into the military in Israel and the resistance in Israel, things were completely different. We talk about very formal style, in the beginning, very much a technical style. This is the problem, that's the solution, this is the problem, here's the solution. From the very basic of striking with the hand or striking with a weapon to defending with the hand or defending with the weapon, or jumping on a sentry and doing killing techniques military style. And when things went into the civil, the main thing was self-defense, de-escalate, prevent, and he used to say one thing that was really explaining this. He said, if somebody is trying to choke you, do this educational stop and say to him, please let me go. And then he was saying, he was happy that I was going, meaning this strike that was stopping him at the chest area, pushing a little bit in the throat area, clavicle notch here, and feeling this, that you do know what you're doing, the one who's defending, and all you want is to stay away, and please don't fight with me, let me go in peace, the other person would feel that you got the capabilities, but you really want to de-escalate and remove yourself from danger zone. And that was his mentality. Let's try to prevent and de-escalate. If not, do whatever you need, according to the law, obviously, and even terminate the enemy. Several days ago, with the global international teams of KMG, we were near Imi's grave and commemorating him and his departure, his acts, and his presence to us. So here's a few shots from there. One time, he told one of his students, still active guy, he's a little bit strange. He's strange back then also. He told him, give me a kick to the groin. The guy gave him a heel kick to the chin. And Imi did like this, kick my groin, please. That's it. No shouting on him, no complaints, no nothing. Something went wrong. Okay, do again. יתגדל ויתקדש שמי רבה.
אמן.
בעל מה דיברך בקרעותי וימליך מלכותי וישמח פה כנה ויקרב משיחי אמן בחייכון וביומכון ובחיי בכל בית ישראל בעגלה ובזמן קרי ואמרו אמן.
אמן.
יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם ולעולמי עלמיה יתברך. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם ולעולמי עלמיה יתברך וישתבח ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתעלל שמי קדקודשה בריחו.
אמן.
The idea is to make a seminar to the students that will include several of Imi's characteristic techniques on one hand, and on the other hand, some advanced or variations of these techniques that include and incorporate his main principles. So here are the techniques from that line to be delivered in the seminar to commemorate 20 years for Imi. And of course, main thing is to thank for the gift of Krav-Maga.
Fencing game, simple fencing game is the last thing in the warm-up. Well, like you have a blade in the hand, try to touch me, I try to touch you, basically like this, and it's also, remember, with the body motions. Okay, then we have the knife, the oriental piece. So the basic technique would be against the oriental medium range, moving diagonally forward, he's attacking me. Characteristic for him, he will need to take him down. And here, take the knife. Here's the next. Here's the variation that we have a weapon from the side. Straight, no, okay. So he's attacking. And that one, with the block, second block with a spin, moving out of channel, naturally, because the spin is a bit later than the previous, the frontal technique. So this is the knife situation. If you do have more time, you can train knife towards the stomach in the real this type of technique, which is also very characteristic in this direction. Defend, attack. From here, continuing out, although, one more time, he was emphasizing grabbing. When we had less problems with very fast, low attacks. Against a stick overhead, one hand, basic technique, we all know it, he attacks. So remember to emphasize the hand defense with a very low elbow slowly. Yes. So this is the range, yes? So the hand defense, very low. Precise, elbow is low. Then the body defense, which is composed of the leaning forward and the stepping forward together. And remember this, mention this in obedience to the partner, the students. And after that, move away or disarm the person. We take this one and with the stone, this principle. With the stone, he's doing the over slowly and touch. And that's the problem, the elbow is out. There's a big hole. Defending near the thumb. Yes. Slowly. This time the leaning is less. You need to aim to the stone area itself and actually striking as soon as you can. And then converting this stabbing defense to the direction of the stone, especially when it is horizontal. So horizontal stone attack. So here we have a situation of a very early defense. If the defense will be late, it's impossible. We have to do that one. And moving in and protecting with 45 degrees near the stone. That's another type of defense. We are only keeping the straight one. So that's the idea. So early stabbing motion. Characteristic to Imi was a pistol from behind. You feel something from behind, or you know that somebody is behind you with a gun. So the basic of hand defense, body defense, but then we stay in the line, we trap in the elbow crook area, we step close as possible, we hit with the elbow forward, immediately grab, give the knee before it falls down, look at the gun, take it. 90 degrees, and then get out, with or without hit with the elbow, and move away from danger zone. Go to the blind side. This can be initially with another control, or with a first strike towards the head, and then decide what you're doing. And the variation of a very, very tight range, that you are going to create the opening between his forearm and his body so you can grab the arm and continue with the kick. And obviously disarming as usual. So these are characteristics to this technique and would be built later on Imi's line. The next technique is with a pistol. Again, very characteristic to Imi's way. Basic pistol from the front. It had some changes during the years. Still with Imi's time, that's the technique. We are saying that this, hand defense, body defense, push into this direction. Control with a strong grip and the bone is parallel to the gun, same line. Lower your shoulder, continue to push, hit as soon as you can, be as soon as you can behind the gun, you are breaking the direction of the gun, taking the gun down and grabbing the hammer sight as soon as we can with a good hook. We are about 45 degrees from the side, more or less. We turn the gun 90 degrees to me, 90 degrees to the ground, and then we step before pulling. And if we don't have a place to step, or because he went away, and this, of course, we don't need to step. And if we cannot step, we can pull down. That's the base. After that, if you need the gun, but remember, the police may shoot you. Okay? You are being perceived as a dangerous person. And then the different variations. Thank you, guys. enjoy this teaching, enjoy life, enjoy Krav-Maga and KMG. Thank you for Jakub and Dragan for demonstrating with me, for Alberto behind the camera at the moment and demonstrating initially.
So, 20 years after Imi passed away, there are thousands of instructors, tens of thousands of students around the world, people that are going more in his line or less in his line, people who are dedicated, and of course there are those who are copycats and trying just to make a quick buck just because Krav-Maga is becoming famous or became famous. Anyhow, for us, for me personally, you know, spending so many years, 24 years with him and my best friend in a way for many years, and like a family, at least his family that I said that I was like a son to him. It's, you know, he's missed, but if he's looking at us from up there somewhere, he definitely sees how people are coming his way. And the system is spreading and people learn how to defend themselves, how to defend other people. And with a set of mind that we don't like to be violent, we try not to be violent, but if we have no alternative, then we will do what we need to do in order to win. And this can be just a defense and run away, and this can be extremely aggressive attacks and then walk away in peace, or military style, law enforcement, VIP protection, very aggressive, very determined, very courageous acts. And Krav-Maga of today, teaching you mentally, physically, technically, and tactically how to deal with violent confrontations and eventually creating better version of yourself. Just because you know how to handle yourself better, just because you are better fit mentally and physically to deal with life. So, guys, enjoy life. Imi did. All the best.